Hi everyone. In this video, we can discuss various programs using SIC and SICXC. We can understand the instructions of SIC and SICXC and can see some of the programs in SIC and SICXC. Instructions of SIC and SICXC. So this whatever instructions we are using in SIC, that also can be used in SICXC. Plus some SICXC is having some additional instructions. So here see the first instruction LDAM. LDA means load accumulator with the content of the memory address M. So A, this content, this bracket represents the content. Content of the memory address M is loaded into the accumulator. Next, the next instruction is the STAM. STA is the opposite of LDA, which means store accumulator content to the memory address M. So here it shows the content of the this accumulator, value in the accumulator is stored into the memory address. Then see the next instruction LDCH. This is for loading character. LDCHM. The character data in the memory address M is loaded into register A. Opposite of this is done by STCH. Store character to the memory location. So the character in the accumulator is stored to the memory address M. These all instructions are there in SICXC plus some additional instructions. For example, for arithmetic instructions, addition, subtraction, this SIC use add, sub, etc. SICXC has one other instruction called add R, register to register operations. So here see add R, R1, R2. This does R2 plus R1, content of R2 added with content of R1, and the answer is stored in the register R2. That is important. Answer is stored in the second register R2. Next, we can see the add instruction, which is an arithmetic instruction. Addition means it is a binary operation. So two operands should be there. But here we have given only one operand, the memory location M. So the other operand is in the accumulator by default. So add M, which adds the content of the accumulator with the content of the memory address, and the answer is stored in the accumulator. Similarly, sub M, mul M, div M, all instructions stores the results in the accumulator. Next is the compare instruction, COMPM. This compares two values. So one value will be by default in the accumulator, and the other value is given as the operand. So accumulator value and the memory address value are, content of the memory address are compared. And according to the result of the comparison, condition code is set, which means a type of flag that is set. If the first value is less than, the less than flag is set. First value is greater than, the greater than flag is set. And both are equal means the equal to flag is set. Now the jump instructions, JM, jump to the memory address. This is unconditional jump. Without any condition, jumps to the program control is transferred to this memory address M, which means that memory address is loaded into the program counter. Program counter always stores the address of the next instruction to be executed. So JM means the next instruction should be executed is at the memory address M. So that value is loaded into the program counter. Then conditional jump instruction is JLT, which checks the condition code. If it is set to less than, this jumps to the memory location M, which means that this M is loaded into the program counter. Similar to this, JGT is the jump greater than. That is, if the value, the condition code is set to greater than, then JEQ, which means the condition code is equal to. According to that, this conditional jump instruction works. Next is JSUB, jump to subroutine. This is similar to function calls in high-level languages. When a function call is encountered, the program control transfers to the function definition. Similar to this, JSUB M means the program control transfers to this memory address and the contents instructions from this memory address onwards gets executed, which means the current value in the program counter, current address in the program counter is stored in a register L, linkage register, and this memory address value is stored to the program counter. So program execution starts from this memory address. Then RSUB instruction. RSUB is for returning from the subroutine. It is similar to return statement in functions. So RSUB means it has to return to the program. So this linkage register, we have already stored the return address that is given to the program counter. Similar in same instructions can be used in SICXC. Next is input output instructions. TD, test device. In this instruction, we have to check whether the input device is ready. TDM. M is the device number. Then next is RDM, reading from the input device. So here M is the device number. So reading from a device, for example, input devices can be a keyboard. So reading from that device, it will be read in 8 bit, that is 1 byte. So this is moved to the rightmost 8 bits of the accumulator. WD does the reverse process, that is the rightmost 8 bits of the accumulator is moved back to the device specified by M, which is the output device. Write a program for alpha equal to 5. So the variable alpha is assigned a constant value 5. We had to write this program in SIC and also in SIC, XC. So first we can see that in SIC. For a high level language like C language, if this question comes, how we will do? We will declare the variable first. So here the variable is alpha, 5 is a constant. So int alpha, then alpha equal to 5. So here variable means memory location in assembly language. So again this alpha, this variable we have to declare. So assembly languages we will declare at the end of the program. So this is the declaration for alpha. Alpha reserve word 1, which means alpha is a memory location reserving one word of memory for alpha. Since it is an integer, integers will take 3 bytes or one word. So it is reserved one word, and whatever value we can give to alpha, that will be in this memory location, going to this memory location. Again, we are using a constant here, 5. So that constant also has to be declared here. We cannot directly use constants in SIC language with the instruction. So constant also I had to again. For declaring integer constant, we have to use the keyword or assembler directive word. Word means this one word of memory, which means 3 byte to hold this integer value. Five. So this 5 becomes a constant. In high level language, we will give like hash defined pi equal to 3.14. After that statement, pi, the name becomes 3.14. So similar to that, this 5, the word becomes 5. Then now we can, how we will assign to this memory location alpha the value 5. Directly, we cannot give alpha equal to 5. Directly, we cannot access the memory. So first, we have to move the value to the accumulator. And then from the accumulator, we have to move it to the memory locations. So that is done here, LDA 5. LDA means load accumulator with this 5. 5 means it's a constant 5. So accumulator is loaded with value 5. Then STA alpha, which means store accumulator content to the memory location alpha. So now the accumulator has the value 5. That 5 is moved to alpha. Alpha, what is alpha? Alpha is a memory location. So it is moved to the memory location alpha.
So this is the SIC program for doing alpha equal to 5. So this alpha and 5 are integers. Same program, how we can write in SICXC. So SICXC, more instruction addressing modes are there, more instructions are there, instruction formats are there. So we can reduce the number of code here in SICXC. So in SICXC, so here LDA we have given the name 5. But in SICXC, we can directly give the value itself. So no need of declaring the constant 5 word 5. We can directly give the value 5 over here. So this is hash symbol is there. So that is the immediate mode. So directly I am loading LDA hash 5, then STA alpha. STA store accumulator content to the memory location alpha. Alpha reserved 1. Write the program for C1 equal to cell. So here we had to assign a character constant to a character variable. So character constant is set. This written in single quotes. It has to be assigned to the memory location C1. So characters in assembly language, it will be having 8 bit or 1 byte of storage. So first we have to do is, we have to declare this character variable and also this character constant. So this character variable declaring here C1 reserve, C1 is a character variable, C1 reserve byte. For characters, instead of reserve word, we had to use reserve byte, 1 byte. We had to reserve 1 byte. C1 reserve byte 1. And character constant, we will use the word byte instead of word. So this is a character constant, char set, C set. Since it is a character, to identify that we had to prefix it with the letter C, then in single quotes set. So this is character constant. Then instead of LDA, we will be using LDCH, load accumulator with a character, char set. Char set is the constant set. So constant set, the value is loaded into the accumulator. Then that value is given to the C1, that is the memory location C1. So this is how the one character is stored to the memory location C1. So one more thing we have to notice here is, here in assembly language we are using indenting. So that is the first, it is written in three columns. So the first column is used for the labels, that is variable names or user given names it is used. And the second column is used for the opcode. And the third column, we are writing the operands. Now the same program in SICXC, how we'll use in SICXC, instead the constant, we can give direct values. So the ASCII value of set we can give here using the immediate mode. So LDA hash 90. So this ASCII value of Z is loaded into the accumulator, and then STCH store that character into the memory location C1. Since we are giving immediate value here, we'll use LDA and then storing that value of that character Z into the memory location C1. So here we are giving C1 reserve byte 1.
Program to perform the operation beta equal to alpha plus incr minus 1. So here, these all are integers. We have to add alpha and incr and subtract 1 from the result and store the answer into the memory location beta. So alpha, incr and beta are the variables used here. So these variables have to be declared. Alpha, reserve word 1. 1 word is reserved for alpha. Then beta, reserve word 1. Incr, reserved word 1. Again, we are using a constant 1 over here. So 1 is a constant. So 1 word 1. Integer constants are declared using word. Now the operation we have to do here is, we have to add this alpha and incr, the contents of these memory locations, and subtract 1 from this. So first we will load alpha into the register A, then add incr with it, then subtract 1 from the result and store the result back to beta. So here see, load accumulator, LDA means load accumulator alpha with the content of the memory location alpha. Then the value in the memory location alpha is loaded into register A. Add INCR. In the add instruction, one operand will be there in the accumulator. Other operand is given here. So accumulator content is added with INCR, and again the result will be there in the accumulator itself. That is alpha plus INCR is there in the accumulator. Now we have to subtract 1 from the result. So sub 1 instruction subtract the 1 from the accumulator content, and again the result will be there in the accumulator. So now the accumulator contains alpha plus INCR minus 1. STA beta, store the accumulator content into the memory location beta. So now beta has the result. So this is the SIC program for doing the operation beta equal to alpha plus INCR minus 1. The same program we can write using SICXC. So while writing using SICXC, there are many differences. The program logic, everything is same, but we need not declare constants in SICXC. Instead of constants, direct value we can give. Then again, we can use register to register instructions. Instead of add, we can use add R with two operands, registers. And we can use additional registers like S and T, general purpose registers. So here I am loading load S, LDS, INCR. INCR value is in the S register. LDA alpha. Alpha is there in the accumulator A. Add R S, A. This instruction adds the contents of S and A and store the result in the second register A. S and A means alpha plus INCR. That value will be there in accumulator. Now I had to subtract 1. So here I can use direct value because it is SICXC. So immediate values will be represented by prefixing it with hash. Sub hash 1. That means this accumulator content minus 1. That is INCR plus alpha minus 1. And STA beta. STA beta means store accumulator content back into this beta, memory location beta. So here I have only declared the variables. Constant declaration can be avoided.
Thank you, everyone.